Kiffner for such a long time. Is she all right?
She wasn't here this morning.
No.
I saw her... I wasn't here last week. I was at Christchurch. She's certainly here on Easter Day. Yes. Yeah. As far as I know, she's okay.
Well, the other person I was wondering about was Charles, who was a regular attendant at the 12:30 on... The 12:30
Charles Nichols. Charles Nichols. He's usually at Christchurch on a Sunday.
Oh, Christchurch.
Yeah. He's very regular at Christchurch. He lives down on the embankment.
I think, well, are we talking about this? I'm talking about Charles.
Charles Nichols?
Yeah, I didn't know.
Who's he usually here?
Yes.
He's had his foot in a boot recently.
That's it.
Yes, he's usually at Christchurch. Normally he's there on a Sunday morning. If he remembers to wake up.
just had to stay for your Evensong. It's such a glorious Evensong with Stanford, and it's just my scene. Is that a Compton console?
It is. Lovely. It's about 90 years old now, the Compton. Yeah. Still works very, very well. It's all tucked over there, of course.
I was in the trade at one stage.
Oh, right. No, I love it. It's just such a fabulous.
Compton did some lovely work.
Certainly really cleverly done. You know, so compact.
I've got work to do. I like your voluntaries.
Thank you. Good afternoon and welcome to St. Luke's on this third Sunday of Easter and to Choral Evensong. We praise God in the singing of the hymn 317. Appointed psalm is number 142 on page 305. Please be seated.
Thank you. first lesson is taken from the book of Deuteronomy. The Lord did not set his love upon you, nor choose you, because ye were more in number than any people, for ye were the fewest of all people. But because the Lord loved you, and because he would keep the oath which he had sworn unto your fathers, hath the Lord brought you out with a mighty hand, and redeemed you out of the house of bondmen, from the hand of Pharaoh, king of Egypt. Know therefore that the Lord thy God, he is God, the faithful God, which keepeth covenant and mercy with them that love him, and keep his commandments to 1,000 generations, and repayeth them that hate him to their face. To destroy them, he will not be slack to him that hateth him, he will repay him to his face. Thou shalt therefore keep the commandments and the statutes and the judgments which I command thee this day to do them. Wherefore it shall come to pass, if ye hearken to these judgments and keep and do them, that the Lord thy God shall keep unto thee the covenant and the mercy which he swore unto thy fathers. And he will love thee and bless thee and multiply thee. He will also bless the fruit of thy womb and the fruit of thy land, thy corn and thy wine and thine oil, the increase of thy kine and the flocks of thy sheep, in the land which he swore unto thy fathers to give thee. Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you.
A reading from the book of Revelation. To the angel of the church in Ephesus, write, these are the words of him who holds the seven stars in his right hand, who walks among the seven golden lampstands. I know your works, your toil, and your patient endurance. I know that you cannot tolerate evildoers. You have tested those who claim to be apostles, but are not, and have found them to be false. I also know that you are enduring patiently and bearing up for the sake of my name, and that you have not grown weary. But I have this against you, that you have abandoned the love you had at first. Remember them from what you have fallen. Repent and do the works you did at first. If not, I will come to you and remove your lampstand from its place, unless you repent. Yet this is to your credit. You hate the works of the Nicolaitans, which I also hate. Let anyone that has an ear listen to what the Spirit is saying to the churches. To everyone who conquers, I will give permission to eat from the tree of life that is in the paradise of God. And to the angel of the church in Smyrna, write, these are the words of the first and the last, who was dead and came to life. I know your affliction and your poverty, even though you are rich. I know the slander on the part of those who say that they are Jews and are not, but are a synagogue of Satan. Do not fear what you are about to suffer. Beware, the devil is about to throw some of you into prison, so that you may be tested, and for 10 days you will have affliction. Be faithful unto death, and I will give you the crown of life. Let anyone who has an ear listen to what the Spirit is saying to the churches. Whoever conquers will not be harmed by the second death. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. blessed us with righteousness.
And make the
God, who has given thine only Son to be unto us both a sacrifice for sin and also an ensample of godly life, give us grace that we may always most thankfully receive that his inestimable benefit, and also daily endeavor ourselves to follow the blessed steps of his holy life. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
The choir sings the anthem by Ray Vaughan Williams, "Let all the world in every corner sing, My God and King."
Oh,
the name of the risen Christ, let us pray to the Father through the power of the Spirit. Jesus, light of the world, bring the light and peace of your gospel to the nations of the world. Let all the world in every corner sing, My God and King. We pray for the nations of the Middle East, that hearts may be turned to justice, compassion and equity for all your children, Lord. Jesus, bread of life, give food to the hungry and nourish us all with your body. We remember the people of Gaza and Sudan and all who hunger for bread and for life today. Jesus, our way, our truth, our life. We pray for your church that we may be filled with your life. For Sarah and Emma, our bishops. For all who minister your love in this parish. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Jesus, good shepherd, who gave his life for the sheep, recover the straggler, bind up the injured, strengthen the sick. Among them we remember Ian Lowe, Harriet Keville Davis, Nick Power, Alistair Lynn, Jack Lovell, Will Jaffrey, Margaret Lawrence, Jill Tainer, and Alan Taylor. We pray for those who have lived and died, and among them John Hutchinson and Olinda Aden. And at their year's mind, Rowena Bulos and Sally Ann Sanderson. Jesus, the resurrection and the life, we give you thanks for all who have lived and believed in you. Raise us, we pray, with these and all your saints to eternal life. In your mercy, hear us, risen Lord. Accept our prayers and guide us always in the way of your life. Let all the world in every corner sing, My God and King. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the eternal covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, resting in you this day and always. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you. Amen.
Thank you.
Yes, quite.
Bess is quite good at doing short prayers, isn't he? I mean, in the sense of he says something and then...
And then stops.
So that's actually... It's the right technique.
Yeah. Yeah, he's in a care home. Well, I assume he's still in a care home in Southport. He went into a care home in Ealing, and I went to see him a few times in Ealing. The gorillas place. If you stood still for 2 seconds, you couldn't move your feet because they start to come out. And he went into hospital, and then refused to come back. Because they said they couldn't go. So he was in hospital for about 3 months, bed pocket, while they tried to find him somewhere. And this is just because he's a highly interesting
son.
So he needs a lot of care.
Right. I remember Emma, this is like, she shows you how long ago, was saying, he's
97 now. And he, yeah, remarkable. And he, but I sent messages, I sent Christmas cards and birthday cards and Easter cards. And then I rang up and said, look, would it be worth me coming? He said, what I'm asking is he still alive?
That's what they said.
And they said, we can't tell you, you're not a relative.
Oh my God.
I said, Miss Parish Prince.
Or worse. What status do you have to declare?
Yeah, exactly.
That does seem odd.
So I said, well, put it this way, would it be a wasted journey if I came to see him? And they said, it wouldn't be a wasted journey, but that's if he wanted to see you. So I thought, how unhelpful can you be?
That's tricky, because...
Oh, they're really tricky, really tricky.
And also, the weird thing is, some people, you know, if the question was asked to him, like, their letter, do you want to see a parish priest of old?
Yeah.
Some of them might have said, oh, my brother. It doesn't mean he wouldn't want to see you, it's just at that moment in time.
Exactly.
It's really
It's a sad oath.
I think that's a hard thing when people sort of pretend stuff, when they fall out of the orbit. It's very hard to know, are they still in the orbit? Because he was kind of an organy thing, I always thought a little bit more, the first time it happened, I was thinking, you assume I'll be back in a few weeks. You know, then of course it doesn't.
He was John Deal, he was a great chum.
That's right. He used to sort of hang around the back of the Tweedledum and Tweedledee.
I always remember John Deal coming into the office and there. Tracy said, oh, it's a very smart new raincoat you've got, John. And I thought, I recognise that sort of raincoat. And she said, where did you get it from? Was it from Peter Jones? He said, no, I'm not going to spend good money at their prices. He said, I got it from an army and navy. I said, yeah, it's East German Portugal, isn't it? He said, oh, I think it might be. He said, I thought it was in German inside. Surplus stores.
That's right, we used to get, candy, things, because why not?
Exactly. Made to last.